beautiful memory. This block. I grew up over here.
It's so great to have him here.
Oh, yeah. Great, great. A lot of history.
Families that live here in every aspect of life, you know that nothing is more important in that conversation than making sure that the sons and daughters of that generation, the sons and daughters of those families who stayed here, who persevered, who worked hard, are able to carry the torch towards a better tomorrow for this community. And when you look at all of the turnaround, and when you look at the work that the community board, and I want to thank all of the community board, two members that are here, the advocacy that has happened in this community for so long, Rafael Salamanca was involved in that. Through his work, not only in healthcare, but as a district manager, I saw firsthand one of the hardest working young people I've ever seen, dedicated to every cause, no matter how small or large. He did his homework, he did his diligence, he did what he needed to do. He made sure that those of us that were elected office did everything that we needed to do to address those issues. And so when he was elected to this position, it was so fitting that someone like him ascend to the city council and continue that work from the position of that seat. And so we're extremely grateful for his leadership. But it's also a message that, you know, in politics, they teach you all politics are local. Well, Rafael has never forgotten that. And this office opening, this location, the historic relevance of this location that he's going to talk about speaks to someone who understands that he is here because of you, that he is here to serve because of the community that elected him and empowered him, and that everything that he does in this office is to the betterment of this community and to the lives of the people of this community in the South Bronx. So we're grateful to Rafael, we're grateful to all of you for empowering him, and now we need to make sure that this community office, that this headquarters of change, that this office of empowerment, with the name Rafael Salamanca on the front door, is seen as a home to all and a place to find comfort, assistance, and empowerment to make sure that we continue to drive that change and that agenda in the right direction. And we know we have a steward, we know we have a captain, we know we have a leader like Rafael Salamanca moving us in the right direction. So thank you all for being here, excited to be here, and so blessed and grateful to you. On that note, I get to bring up the man of honor. Ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome with a round of applause our great council member, Rafael Salamanca.
Thank you, Marcos. Thank you, Marcos, for those kind words. Tell you, Marcos, please give Marcos a big hand of applause. Marcos is awesome. Before I begin, I couldn't be here today if I didn't have the support of my family. I have my wife with me today, Jesenia Ponte. I also have my son with me, Justin, here with us today. Also want to acknowledge some of the elected officials that are here with me today. First, we have our council members. We have Councilmember Cohen, who's here with us today. Councilmember Richard Torres is here with us today. Councilmember Gibson is here with us today. Councilmember Levine is here with us today as well. our assembly members, we have Councilmember Jose Rivera, who's here with us today. We have Victor Pichardo, who's here with us today. We have Mark Jonai, who's here with us today. We have Michael Blake, who's here with us today. And of course, we have Assemblyman Marcos Crespo, who's here with us today as well. We have our Deputy Borough President, Aurelia Green. Thank you for your kind words. We also have Senator Jose Serrano, who's here with us today. We have Ramon Martinez. I don't know if he's still here. He's the Chief of Staff for the Speaker's Office. He's here with us today. And then we have Governor Cuomo staff who's here, DA Darcel Clark staff who's here, City Controller Scott Stringer staff who's here, Public Advocate Letitia Jane staff is here, Senator Diaz staff is here, Community Board 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, and 4 is here with us today. UFC is here with us today. The 411 Precinct is here with us today. Parks Department is here with us today. And Bronx Community Board 2 is here with us today. So when I first got elected, I was looking at new space. And immediately I knew where I wanted to come. I wanted to come to Southern Boulevard in Westchester. This is my hometown. This is where I was born and raised. This is the heart of the South Bronx. So I was looking around, looking for space. And what was so marvelous about this space is that my mom used to work here. I promise I wouldn't do that. So my mom worked here for Paloma Hernandez. She worked here for a few years. And then in 2000, I started my career in this very building. I started working here in this building. And I worked here for about 7 years. I worked for Paloma Hernandez and Dr. Izquierdo. They gave me the opportunity. I am here because of them. Thank you very much. And then I went on, I became a center director for an organization called Community Healthcare Network, and then I came back as a district manager for Bronx Community Board 2. And I was here for about 5.5 years. And boy, did we rock. We had a lot of successes. We cleaned up Hunts Point. We ensured that we brought in affordable housing. We ensured that we had after-school programs for our youth. And we ensured that the community's voice was heard. And then I had the opportunity to run for city council, and you know, I had the support of all my elected officials, which is I can say they have been marvelous. I cannot thank you enough, especially for the council delegation, the Bronx delegation. You guys have really helped me, especially in the time when I came in on budget time. So this building, as you can see, is very special to me. So with that, you know, I really want to do this ribbon cutting. Just want to tell you about some of the service that we have here. We're open Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. We're going to have constituent services every day of the week. We're not going to close. Once a week, we have an immigration attorney who is dealing with any issues that you have in terms of citizenship. And with this new budget, I also got a legal aid attorney who will be here once a week to help with housing issues, and she will go to court with you. That's a promise that I did for my community, and that's what we have here. I want to thank you all for coming out, and I ask you, after this, we'll do our ribbon cutting. Enjoy the food, enjoy the space. I'm here to serve you. Thank you. God bless.